Hey guys, Andrew here. Today we're playing some more No One But You. When we last left off, we had just basically taken the bus ride to go to our Hot Springs Resort vacation, and I had a really big tangent about that, and that's not for right now, though. Anyways, we were left with this choice of whether to go in the Hot Springs now or go in them later, so let's get back to the story. Do I really want to go in right away? It's bound to be crowded. Go in now? What am I saying? We're at the hot springs. What else would I do with myself? All right, I'm in. There's the Hideki, I know. Just give me a second to grab my camera, then I'll be right behind you. You know, I actually kind of hope he's planning to use that camera to peep on the girls. I don't want to think about the alternative. What? What is the alternative? Is the alternative that he takes pictures of his own dick and then gives it to the girls? Like, I don't really know what. What do you mean better than the alternative? Like, I would rather him commit a crime than the alternative of not committing a crime? I don't know, both are a crime, both are bad. So now this is the life. Slowly roasting in the steam, lapping up the rays, just chilling with my bud, I don't know where to begin correcting that statement. You've ever been to a hot spring resort, Hideki? Nah, I've never lived close to one, and my mother's idea of vacation is a little more extreme. It's nice to finally have the opportunity, though.
Couldn't agree with you more.
Haha, stop it! No way, I've been waiting all day to do this. Me too, and just look at the size of those things. Guys, cut it out.
Before we knew it, Ryu and I had pressed our ears to the partition between the boys' bath and the girls'.
Why is it made out of bamboo and not cement? I mean, come on, man, it's like 2015, 2016. You can't be doing that kind of shit. Wooden walls are not enough.
Dude, are they talking about what I think they're talking about?
I'm not usually one to encourage Ryu, but in this case, God, I hope so.
Stop it, I swear, I'll tell the teacher. Oh, don't be like that. Look, I'll show you mine. I don't want to see that, I told you, I don't swing that way. Like that matters, come on, get that cute little tush over here. Kya, stop, seriously, cut it out. Wow, so soft and plump, I'm envious of your future boyfriend. I've got to go to the toilet. Me too. Yep, me too.
Oh my god, girls, please, hold it in. One by one, the boys on our side fled the hot spring, all hiding their shame as they did.
Don't read too much into this, but...
Just go. No sooner had the words left my mouth than Ryu took off, following the same sequence of events as all the others. I thought about doing the same, but then I realized something. Am I the last one left? Huh. Well, if I'm the only one in here, then I guess it doesn't really matter if I stay or not, huh? Huh. I waited for further scandalous revelations to pour over from the girl's side, eagerly awaiting a continuation of the playful conversation from moments ago.
Is that the last of them? Yeah, seems that way.
Instead of arousing promises of skinship, however, I was greeted with something far more realistic.
Ha ha ha, I can't believe the boys fell for that. I know, right? Just how stupid are they?
Eh?
Seriously, boys only ever think about their genitals, huh? Filthy animals. Oh, like you're one to talk. I've seen the way you look at Akira from class. What? I do not. Yeah, we all know what's going on there. Just like Megumi and Hideki, anybody with a brain knows to keep their distance.
Huh? What are they talking about? And how did this conversation suddenly become about me?
Really? I don't know what she sees in him. She isn't the only one either, not that I'd ever name names or anything. Oh please, I know you're just dying to dish.
Hang on a second. Are these girls saying what I think they're saying? Huh. Nah, couldn't be. They must have realized that I'm the last one in here, so now they're teasing me.
Actually, I'm pretty sure Shiro has a thing for Hideki. Shiro Amiyami? Shiro
How do you say that? Amamiya?
Shiro Amamiya?
I think that's how you pronounce it. Amamiya. Yeah, that's how you pronounce it.
Amamiya?
Sorry, I just wanted to get the names right. It's rude not to get names right, you know?
Yeah, her, the girl with the white hair who aced all the exams. Damn, I should have known her heart already belonged to someone else.
Huh. Well, that was more than I needed to hear. It's probably best that I don't think about it too much, though it was kind of flattering in a way. Once the boys started to reappear in the hot springs, I made my exit. There were other baths I could have entered, ones with fewer people, but after soaking for so long, I'd had enough. Phew, that was nauseating. Maybe I shouldn't have gone in so soon after getting off the bus. It really didn't help with my motion sickness at all. Why would it help? Why would you think that soaking in hot water would help your motion sickness, dude? Like, trust me, I've been motion sickness before, and the last thing I want to do is take a hot bath right after getting out of... I just want to lay down and sleep. I should just go back to my room, lay down, and enjoy a nice, quiet... Aki-kun! Oh, God, why?
Ah, it is Hideki. I see you went in straight away too.
Yep, I just couldn't help myself. For better or worse.
Shiro and I headed straight in, after inquiring about mixed baths, of course.
Mixed baths? As in boys and girls together in the same bath?
No, Megumi wasn't serious about that.
Eh, of course I was serious. After all, what's the point of coming to a hot springs resort if I can't bathe with Hidi?
Huh. Well, I'm going home now. See you later.
Hey, don't be like that. I know you're disappointed about the mixed bathing, but that doesn't mean we can't still enjoy the trip.
I don't think that's what Hideki was getting at.
Thank you, Shiro, for being the one sane person I know.
Hey, Aki-kun, why don't you come to our room? I brought board games and Shiro brought snacks, so what you say you have some fun?
Board games and snacks. That isn't enough to lure a child in the digital age, such as myself. On the other hand, it might be a good opportunity to spend some time with Shiro. We don't get to spend all that much time together, so I'd like to hang out with her, just the two of us. And Megumi. Even so, nah, not tonight. Maybe tomorrow.
Eh, why not? If it's because Shiro will be there, I can always...
No, it's nothing like that. I'm just tired. After the lengthy trip here, followed by a long soak, I think I need some rest.
Oh, I see.
Well, that can't be helped. Guess I'll see you tomorrow.
Haha, you know it. Not letting the rejection get to them, Shiro and Megumi walked away without further complaint. I feel bad about turning them down, but I'm just not feeling up to that right now. What I need now is rest. Giving in to my earthly desires, I returned to my room and hopped into bed. Ah, this is actually pretty comfortable. Apparently we're still in the lobby sleeping. Okay. There's a nice breeze coming in from the window. The blanket is warm, my bed is soft. If I'm not careful, I might really... doze off. I guess I dozed off. Eh? What the hell? As I looked around the room, I recognized the scenery outside through the window, and I immediately remembered where I was. Right, the hot springs. Man, I must have fallen asleep as soon as my head hit the pillow. What time is it anyway? I turned on my phone to check the time. 11:45 p.m.? What the hell? Unbelievable. I slept the whole first day away. Sensing that something was amiss, I took another look around the room. Hang on a minute, where's Ryu? I checked the bed next to mine, but found nobody there. Strange, did he return to the wrong room? Nah, knowing Ryu, he's probably raiding some poor girl's belongings. In a way, I kind of hope he gets caught. Though chances are he wouldn't learn his lesson even then. As I pondered Ryu's whereabouts, a far more pressing matter came to mind. Phew, much better. It may be inconvenient to get up and go to the toilet in the middle of the night, but it certainly beats doing so without getting up. At any rate, now that I'm wide awake, I need to find something to do. Unfortunately, given the time, I don't think there's anything I really can do. I wouldn't go into the hot springs at this time of night, so that just leaves playing games on my handheld. Without giving the matter any further thought, I returned to my room. Let's see now, where did I put that thing? Shit, I hope I didn't forget to bring a charger. The last thing I want to do is run out of battery now. I continued searching for my handheld gaming console in my bag. Jeez, there's nothing in here but clothes. Why did I pack so much clothing for a 2-day, 1-night trip? That isn't like me. And what's with this underwear? It's all frilly and soft, and, as an ominous feeling spread throughout my body, I turned to look around the room once more. Surely enough, in the bed right next to me was not Ryu. Oh no. Hell no. If that isn't Ryu, then this room is... I look back at the underwear in my hand. Pink, frilly, and covered in love hearts. Either one of the boys in our class is a crossdresser, or I've just committed a horrible crime. Hideki? Oh no, 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 no.
Eh, silly Hideki, don't kiss me there.
Eh? The girl next to me was talking in her sleep. As I took a closer look at the sleeping girl's face, I came to a startling revelation. The room I sneaked into was Megumi's?
Aki-kun, not there. You know I'm sensitive there. Come on, don't tease me. Put it in.
Put what? Oh god, Megumi isn't. Surely she isn't.
You're watching Megumi sleep? I seriously misjudged you, Hideki.
What? I jumped back as Shiro's face appeared right behind me, or beside me, unable to stop myself from shouting in surprise. Shiro?
Sorry to disturb you, but Megumi did get this room to herself, you know.
Crap, I hadn't even thought about the fact that it's two to a room. Please, Shiro, this isn't what it looks like. I just wandered into the wrong room. I was only looking at Megumi to confirm that she wasn't my roommate Ryu.
Likely story.
But it's true.
If that's the case, why do you have her underwear in your hand?
Huh? I looked down at my hand and realized that I was still holding on to Megumi's panties. What can I even say in this situation? I'm sorry.
Honestly, Hideki, that's the kind of stunt I'd expect from Ryu.
It's not like I was after Megumi's panties.
Oh, then whose panties were you F? Huh.
Mid-sentence, Shiro suddenly stopped talking. Shiro?
What? No, I...
Words failed Shiro as she tried to regain her calm.
Forget all that. If you're that intent on watching Megumi sleep, perhaps I should wake her up and let her know.
No, please. Anything, not that. Anything but that.
Oh, but if I don't, how can I rest assured that you won't keep preying on sleepy girls?
Shiro, have I really disgraced myself to that extent in your eyes?
Well, I guess there is one way I can make sure you don't do anything strange.
Do it. I don't care what it is.
Heh, you asked for it.
Oh god, what is she gonna do? After a brief round of negotiations with Shiro, I at last returned to my room. Ryu was still notably absent, but my bag was where I left it, handheld console and all, so I was sure I got the right room. Boy, what a misadventure. I'm lucky that I walked into the room of Megumi and Shiro, rather than that of some random girls I don't know, but still.
These rooms really do all look the same. But at least it's nice and quiet in here.
Yeah, I don't know where Ryu wound up, but it looks like it's just us. And honestly, I'm quite thankful for that. If Ryu woke up to find Shiro and I together like this, I'd never hear the end of it.
Oh, you didn't hear? Ryu was caught peeping in one of the girls' baths earlier, and he's been on his way back home ever since.
Seriously?
Yep, Ryu's long gone.
I thought Shiro was joking at first, but she kept a straight face the entire time, and her steady tone of voice told me it was the truth. Holy crap, Ryu, I can't believe he actually did it. Not that I'm complaining, I'd much rather spend my nights with Shiro than Ryu. So that's why you were so keen on monitoring me.
Hey, I wouldn't say I was keen. I just thought it was the best solution, given the circumstances.
While that does sound like an excuse, I can't say she's wrong.
Though honestly, I wouldn't have minded coming here anyway, if it meant getting away from Megumi's sleep talking.
Ah, so that's it. She's been like that this whole time, huh?
Yeah, pretty much. I haven't gotten a wink of sleep. Sleep talking is one thing, but why are they all sex dreams?
Megumi really was having a sex dream? What's more, the name she was calling out was...
Anyway, now that I found a nice quiet room with a free bed, I'm sure I'll be able to get some sleep.
Huh? Hang on, you plan on sleeping here?
Why not? Ryu won't be using his bed, and I won't be getting any sleep as long as Megumi keeps moaning.
So much for coming here to keep an eye on me. But this is a guy's room. Aren't you worried I might try something while you're asleep?
Heh, you were thinking about what happened in my room? I was only kidding. I know you wouldn't do something like that.
Really?
Of course. I trust you, Hideki. Though, if you'd rather swap rooms with me for the night, I'm sure Megumi wouldn't object.
No, that's okay. I'm more than happy to share a room with you.
Wonderful. Well then, I think it's about time I went to sleep. Good night, Hideki.
Just like that, Shiro put her head on the pillow and closed her eyes. Yeah, night, Shiro. Well, that was interesting. What an interesting development, if I do say so myself. Having spent the night next to Shiro, we both woke up early in the morning so she could return to her room without being seen. We briefly laughed about last night, agreed to sit together on the bus during the return trip, and parted ways. Phew, what a night. Ryu got dragged back home, Shiro spent the night in my room, and I don't even want to think about what happened with Megumi. Even if I slept most of the day away, overall, it was a pretty great day. With those thoughts in mind, the rest of the morning proceeded without issue or fun. One of the teachers took us to some historical place and started telling us about it, because that's what teachers do. I obviously wasn't listening, nor were most of the other students from what I could gather. Nonetheless, his speech dragged on, and before we knew it, noon had come and gone. Man, what a sucky trip. I only had time for one short dip in the hot springs this morning, thanks to that teacher of ours. I actually spent more time pretending to listen to him blather on than I did in the hot springs. Sure, the trip had its up and downs, but if I try to quantify it, this trip was a disappointment. Despite my pessimistic thoughts, brought on by my teacher's compulsion to teach, I'd be lying if I said the trip was a complete waste. Ooh, sins of the father. I guess we're on the Shiro route now, guys. All aboard. Choo-choo. Chugga-chugga-chugga-chugga-chugga-chugga-chugga. Oh, click. I was like, why is it not leaving? I forgot I had to click it to go away. Shoo-shoo. I guess that's the end of the hot springs trip. Or not. Even if we didn't get to spend as much time together as I'd hoped, last night with Shiro certainly was interesting. I'd thought of Shiro as being more reserved and straight-laced, the type to keep her distance and not break the rules so blatantly. Spending time on the school roof is one thing, but to actually sleep in a boy's room on a school trip. Despite finding the event odd, I didn't actually object. If anything, I was excited by nothing. Above all else, however, I was relieved to realize just how much Shiro trusted me. I'm always joking around with my friends, so it's kind of difficult to know where I really stand. But for Shiro to be so relaxed in my presence, and to share a room with me without any hesitation. Huh. No, hang on a second. Doesn't that mean that she doesn't see me as a member of the opposite sex? Okay, it's not like I've ever tried hitting on Shiro or anything, but it's kind of insulting to know that she thinks of me like that. If anything, I had hoped that this trip would be a good opportunity for Shiro and I to get to know one another better. Instead, I've reached a shocking conclusion.
That's baseless. Completely baseless. I mean, you just heard previously that the girls were talking about how Cheryl liked you. You also told Cheryl that she was cute and she blushed and wasn't able to reply properly, and you knew that. Also, when you were inside of the room, when you were mentioning to her that you weren't after Megumi's panties and she thought it was her, she started blushing and having a freak out. Obviously, she actually sees you as the opposite gender and she likes you, but you're just too dense to notice it or something. Just wanted to point that out, that you basically have no basis for why you would think this, that she does not see you as the opposite sex.
Today really isn't my day. Okay. Shaking off my petty aggravation, I headed to the bus, carrying my belongings over my shoulder as I searched for an empty seat. Once again, Shiro was already sitting next to a random girl from our grade, with Yui sitting alone and my more excitable friends taking the back seat. I guess I'll be sitting with Ryu and Megumi once more. Shiro is already sitting next to someone, and I don't think Yui would appreciate the company, which leaves me with the energetic ones by default. As much as I enjoy their company, I'm feeling too lethargic to play along with Megumi and Ryu right now. Honestly, I just want to get back home and go to sleep. Wait, what? Oh my god, come on, are you joking with me? Dude! Okay.
It's another time for Andrew's rants!
Okay, guys. One of the things that was said was specifically that me and Shiro agreed to sit next to each other on the bus ride home. Also, why are you mentioning that Ryu was on the bus when he was clearly brought home the first day? So Ryu's not on the bus anymore. It's only Megumi. So it's just Megumi, it's just Yui, it's just Shiro. But if me and Shiro already made plans to sit next to one another on the bus ride home, which you already said in the plot, then why is it that we're not sitting on the bus ride home going back? Instead, why do you mention that Ryu, who is not there anymore, and Megumi are sitting in the back again, which means that the only person I'm going to be sitting with is Megumi, which means that I should be having a scene where I'm just sitting next to Megumi by myself. This is a basic thing, guys. Like, come on. This is... it's just so aggravating when you do that kind of shit. Just, like, make it consistent. Sorry. I don't mean to be crazy. It's just, like, if you're on a certain route, you give me the thing, you're like, you're on the Shiro route, then, like, give some more Shiro-related stuff, you know? Like, on the bus ride home, there should be a thing, because the other two girls have a thing on the bus ride home. Ugh.
This is another one of Andrew's rants. Thank you for tuning in.
Ugh. After a lengthy, tiring bus ride back to Okutama, I walked back from school to my house. I managed to eventually shake off Megumi and Ryu, at which point I began searching for Shiro. But before I could suggest that we walk home together, she was already long gone. Yet another opportunity missed. Good job, Hideki. Upon entering the house, I immediately noticed how dark it was. All the lights were off, indicating that my mother had either gone out or gone to sleep. I guess I'll be alone tonight, huh? Oh well, at least this way I can go straight to bed. Walking through my silent home, I headed for the staircase, careful not to trip over in the dark. As I reached my room, however, the silence was broken, and I was greeted by a familiar sound. Wait a minute, is that? I walked over to my window, and surely enough, on the other side of the glass was the same dazzling sight I had longed to see. As the moonlight shone down upon her, Shiro gently strummed her acoustic guitar, softly humming to herself as she did.
Ha ha, la la la. If only you knew how much I...
The scene played out as much the same way as it had last time. This time around, however, it didn't take any intervention on my part for Shiro to notice my presence. As she entered the verse, her eyes pierced through the through my window, and a warm smile appeared on her face.
Good evening, Hideki.
Yeah, you too, Shiro. I opened my window as Shiro engaged me, enabling the two of us to speak freely and clearly. I was hoping that we could walk home from school together, but I suppose a private show is just as good. Is there a viewing schedule I should familiarize myself with?
Heh, are you sure you can afford to come to my shows? They may be infrequent, but I charge like a wounded bull, you know?
What? I'm sorry, what? What the hell do you mean you charge like a wounded bull? Like, that doesn't make any sense monetarily. Like, you know, I get what you're saying. Like, you charge, you physically move like a wounded bull, but like, What does that monetarily mean? Like, what's equivalent to a wounded bull in dollars? This is a dumb thing to say. It's dumb to be hung up on it, but it's also dumb to say. Like, I would never be like, hey, Andrew, how much do you charge to do your job? It's like, well, I charge like a wounded bull. It's like, what? Are you saying that you're gonna come to work as a wounded bull? What the fuck are you saying? Aha, the true reason for Shiro's minuscule number of fans has come to light.
But really, music is something you need to fuel, or to feel. I can't just pick up my guitar and play whenever I want to. So on nights when the moon is right, I open my window, pick up my guitar, and play to my heart's content.
Wow, I never knew so much thought went to simply strumming a guitar. I guess that explains why I have no talent for music.
That's okay. If we were all performers, who would watch us play?
Huh. That sounded strangely philosophical. In that case, will I get to sit on some of your performances during summer break? Because if not, I'd like to get a recording to tide me over.
Heh, I'm glad you like it. But I'm sure you'll get plenty of opportunities during summer break. After all, we'll still be neighbor, and it's not like I'm going anywhere for the break.
Ah, is that so? That's a relief. I know that a lot of people tend to leave the city and go on trips during summer break. Heck, in Yui's case, she won't even be in the country.
What about you, Hideki? Will you be going anywhere?
Nope, I have no plans whatsoever. Aside from listening to you, of course.
Jeez, you just don't let up, do you?
Haha, if nothing, I'm nothing if not persistent. And dishonest, of course. The truth is, I have no idea if I'll be going anywhere over the break. After all, with a mother like mine, who's ready to move houses at a moment's notice, nothing is out of the question. So Shiro, you say you aren't going anywhere, but surely you have plans for summer break.
Huh.
Shiro grew silent for a moment as she contemplated the upcoming break.
I don't know. I guess I'll just study for the most part.
Huh. As expected of a straight-A student, huh?
But I can't have fun too, you know? It's not like I do nothing but study all the time.
No, I know that. You also go ghost hunting, or ghost busting, and janitor killing in your free time, right?
That's right, and I... That isn't it. I don't do that.
Haha, Shiro, you're just too easy. Relax, Shiro. I know what you're trying to say. So you'll be right next door, and up for anything, correct?
Huh, yes, that's what I meant. So if you do have anything planned for summer break, or you get too lonely...
You'll be the first person I call.
Heh, I better be.
Huh. As those words left Shiro's mouth, our conversation suddenly came to a close. Well, I guess it's about time I turned in for the night.
Yes, I suppose it's getting late. We'll just have to resume this conversation tomorrow then, won't we?
You know it.
Huh, you don't have to sound that excited, Hideki. At any rate, I think it's about time I went to sleep as well. I'll see you tomorrow, Hideki.
Good night, Shiro. All right, well, that went over smoothly. Whoa, 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 the days are going by. I thought we were going to talk tomorrow. Now it's like 2 weeks from now. All right, it is nighttime yet again. Any case, I'm going to go ahead and say thank you guys for watching. If you like what you see, go ahead and click subscribe. Otherwise, leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me the worst no one but you player you've ever seen before. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and
bye!